corpora for different languages, let's say for different second languages produced by learners with different first languages, let's say German native speakers who are learning Norwegian or Swedish mother tongue speakers who are learning French. By comparing different languages, you can see the patterns of their linguistic development, and you could probably come to some kind of insights that languages are learned according to a certain system. There is a processability theory that is pretty spread right now by Pinnemann, which also kind of makes a sequence of different morphological and grammatical knowledge that is acquired in a certain path, in a certain way, a certain sequence. And this is studied like language for language separately. There is a kind of an idea that probably there is a universal type of language learning that every learner goes through. Like, for example, everybody first acquires plural of nouns to only later acquire definite forms and so on and so forth. We are kind of breaking down the general descriptors that are given this Common European Framework of Reference for languages into linguistic patterns that we expect learners to know. There are different questions that people are asking depending on the language they are learning. For example, do nominal phrases, which means like a noun and all the attributes that you are using together with it, are they growing according to a certain pattern between the development stages? How do people acquire different morphological patterns, let's say definiteness in the language, and when they stop making mistakes, for example, with that? Why do certain learners omit subjects, though the language demands subject in every sentence? Does it have to do with the first languages, that background? Does it have to do with the structure or with the teaching or with the materials they are presented with? So there are various types of questions that both refer to kind of learning as such, as research, and practical consequences of insights gained in that area. We are developing some kind of tool based on those corpora and insights from corpora to provide new materials to learners. It would be if the data is in the same format and containing the same concepts, containing the same tasks, and all other possible ways is comparable and interoperable, we could just take another corpus from another language and use it in this tool that generates new materials for learners. And this would have a direct influence on the learning within language learning. So that the tools and corpora would be interoperable and pluggable into each other. Indirect would be insights from the studies of that kind that would influence probably testing and assessment approaches in different countries, and the way course books are created and material is scheduled. So it's more like indirect influence on the language learning. I have a lot of trust in Clarin, and I think that Clarin does great work already collecting a lot of tools and resources that can be used for different types of research, which indirectly also can lead to language learning. Among others, I see that, first of all, it could be more networking. All those grants that Clarin offers can help the experts from different languages, from different countries, communicate with each other to come to common standards. And the big hope is that we could create something like some kind of infrastructure for those who are working with second language resources, second language tools, so that, for example, tools for anonymization could be readily available for those who are starting to prepare data for corpus and use the same format. And then the next tool that is necessary is also there and is easy to use. So you kind of have this, through this interface, you access all those tools and all those document formats, guidelines, recommendations, so that the new generation of corpora and different types of resources, not only corpora, probably also lexical resources, would be more, how to say, standardized.